In this video, I am going to discuss the special histological types of invasive carcinoma. There's almost 6 or 7 special histological types of invasive carcinoma. First of all, I will discuss the lobular carcinoma, lobular type of invasive carcinoma. Has got the heterozygous germline mutation and the CDH1 gene, which results in the loss of the E-cadherin, discohesion between the cells that produce the inside the desmoplastic response. Initiate the desmoplastic. If it's metastasized, it will metastasize to the peritoneum, to the retroperitoneum, the ovaries, the uterus, the leptomeninges, the carcinomatous meninges, GIT. This is almost similar to the LCIs, lobular carcinoma in the situ, or the lobular hyperplasia, having the increased risk of the Sigmund Prinz cell gastric carcinoma. These are the ER positive. First of all, I will tell you which tumors are ER positive. This lobular carcinoma is the ER positive. This mucinous choloid, ER positive. This tubular carcinoma is ER positive. And the papillary carcinoma is ER positive. Now come back to the lobular carcinoma. Simply there is a mutation in the E-cadherin, and I have told you earlier in the previous videos what is the role of the E-cadherin protein. Now come to its morphology. These are ER positive. It will present as a hard irregular masses, diffuse infiltrative pattern. Why it has got the diffuse? And because it is metastatic cancer or the invasive carcinoma, but it has got the minimal desmoplasia, difficult to palpate or detect by the imaging. If I talk about the histological finding is similar to its pathogenesis. I mean, discohesive between the tumor cells, Sigmund Ring cells containing the intracytoplasmic mucin droplets, no tubule formation, alveolar and the solid variant, consist of the circumscribed clusters. Now come to the mucinous or the choloid type of invasive carcinoma. As the name suggests, mucinous, filled with the mucin. So it will soft and rubbery, give the appearance of the pale blue-gray gelatins, but having the borders pushing or circumscribed. These are the cluster of the small islands containing the lakes of the mucin, as the name suggests. This is a mucinous. Now come to the tubular. As the name suggests, it will form the tubules, well-formed tubules. Mistakenly, it has been taken for the benign sclerosing lesions. It has got the cribriform pattern, apocrine snouts, these are very similar to the apocrine sweat glands. But they have got the calcification, the lumen. These are the tubules, but there is center. In the center, there are calcification. These are associated with the flat epithelial atypia or atypical lobular hyperplasia, LCIs, low-grade DCIs. Now comes to the inflammatory types. See, this is a tubular. Now comes to the inflammatory side, inflammatory invasive carcinoma. As the name suggests, this mimics the inflammatory lesions, but these are not inflammatory lesions. These are high-grade tumors having the no molecular subtype, having the extensive invasion and the proliferating in the lymphatic channels. What is the main factor for the metastasis or invasions of this tumor is the proliferation in the lymphatic channel. It will spread anywhere in the body. Now come to the secretory type. As the name suggests, it will mimic the lactating breast having the dilated spaces filled with eosinophilic material. Now come to the second last type, that is papillary carcinoma. These are similar to the they are also ER positive. These are true papilla. They will form the true papilla, having the fibrovascular tissue lined by the tumor cells, similar to the papillomas. These are fibrovascular tissue and surrounding by the tumor cells. These are the papillary type. This will form the papilla. It will form the two types of the papilla, the apocrine papilla and the micropapillary papilla. And the what is apocrine? This will resemble the sweat glands, having the large prominent round nuclei, the prominent nucleoli, abundant eosinophilic granular cytoplasm. And if I talk about the micropapillary, it will similar to the cell adherent to each other. Why it's adherent to each other? Because it express the eek adherent and but lack the adhesion to the stroma. These cells are adhesive to each other, but there is no adhesion between the stroma, means there no adhesion to the connective tissue, and form the hollow walls of the cell floating in the intracellular fluids. Now comes to the medullary type, that is due to the BRCA1 mutation. There is a hypermethylation of the BRCA1 promoter region, which result in the downregulation of the BRCA1 expression, which result in the lymphocytic infiltrate, higher survival rate. It gives the better response to the chemotherapy, good outcomes to the host response. There is a good outcome when there is a host response to the tumor antigens. Soft due to the minimal dysplasia, well circumscribed mass. If I talk about its morphology, now comes to its morphology. These are the solid syncytium sheet like mass of large cells, medullary, because these are medullary type. Having the pleomorphic nuclei, because these are the invasive carcinoma, the prominent nucleoli, frequent mitotic figure, moderate to mark lymphocytic infiltration, pushing borders, DCIS is minimal or absent. Now I will give the short summary of this, all the special histological type of invasive carcinoma. Their number one is lobular, it's due to the eukaryotic loss of eukaryotic, the mucin is similar to the mucin, having the lakes of the mucin. These are the cells having the lakes of mucin, secreted similar to the lactating breast, tubular, which will form the tubules, inflammatory, widespread inflammatory because of extensive invasion and the proliferation of lymphatic channels, highly metastasizing cancer. Now comes to the papillary. Papillary has got the three types, the apocrine and the micropapillary. Apocrine similar to the sweat gland, and the micropapillary having the adhesion to each other but doesn't have the adhesion to the stromal cells, like a form of hollow balls of the cells that float in intracellular fluid. Now comes to the medullary. The medullary is the last one, the BRCA1, it's due to the BRCA1 mutation.